What's up, guys? You asked for it, so you're receiving it. You want to know what the best schools are in Ventura, so I'm going to go ahead and tell you what the best schools in Ventura are. All the way from K to 12th grade, they're going to be public schools only. And just a quick reminder, if you haven't seen the best areas to live in Ventura, I'm going to go ahead and link that in the description down below. So as I'm talking about these schools, you have a better idea where it is and if you can see yourself living there. Just a quick introduction before we begin. My name is Raleigh Mendez. I'm a realtor with Berkshire Hathaway Home Services California Realty, and it is my pleasure and my honor to bring this information to you, someone who's considering moving to Ventura. I want you to have the information that you need so you're accurately equipped with the knowledge to make the move here. And when you get here, you're ready to bounce to whatever it is you want to do. You want to go hiking, you already know where to go. You need to know what school your kid wants to go to or needs to go to, you're ready to send them there. What's the best neighborhood? You're ready to live there. That's my job, and I love helping you. I'm glad that you're here. And let's jump straight into the best schools in Ventura, California. To start us off, I'm just going to let you know that Ventura is part of the Ventura Unified School District. And hey, I'm a byproduct of the VUSD. I'm doing pretty well. So I just want to let you know that your kid is in great hands and great teachers when they are part of the Ventura Unified School District. And let's start off with K through fifth grade, the best schools for each area. So let's go into it. The best school for K through fifth grade on the west side of Ventura is going to be the Ventura Charter School of Arts and Global Education. They are a charter school, but they are public. And if you happen to live on the west side, your child has a fairly great chance of getting in because they are in an admissions process. It's all based on a lottery. If you live on the west side, you have a better chance of getting into that school, but they do take applications from other people within all of the Ventura Unified School Districts. So all of the areas I'm going to be mentioning today. If you really like this school and do some research on it, you can go ahead and submit your child to attend there. And just so you know, I'm getting the top picks for these schools by word of mouth, and I'm also doing extra research on niche.com and greatschools.org. These are wonderful websites for you to get all the information and more that you need to know about each school. So I went ahead and did all of this preliminary research for you on what are the best schools. But if you want to jump even further into it, I'll go ahead and link those two websites down below so you can get actual parent and student reviews on each school and all of their offerings. If you live in the Pierrepont area, which is on the beach, the best school for your child to attend is Pierrepont Elementary School, and is very highly rated. I actually have a cousin who teaches there, and she is wonderful and does a great job teaching her kindergarten students. You rest assured, your child is going to be in great hands at Pierrepont, and it's right on the beach, so that's pretty killer as well. If you're in the downtown area, the best school for your kid to attend is going to, again, be the Charter School of Arts and Global Education. And another thing that I want to mention really quick that is wonderful about Ventura is that if you're in the Ventura Unified School District, we have what's called School of Choice. It's still based on lottery, but if you don't like the elementary school in the area that you're living, you have the ability to enter your kid into a lottery of having them attend a different public school in Ventura that you want them to go to. This is great because even though Ventura is a fairly large city, it doesn't take too long to get to other parts of town, so your commute to dropping your child off won't be bad. So I definitely recommend utilizing School of Choice. So the best school for the college area and Midtown is going to be a tie between Mound Elementary School, whereas Mound has a tiny bit higher of a rating. They're still based off of your location, but again, School of Choice. So if you really want your kid to go there, you could enter them into a lottery. The second best option for the college and Midtown area is Poinsettia, another very highly rated school off of greatschools.org and niche.com. And then for the East End, there's another tie between the top two elementary schools, and that's Juana Maria Elementary School and Father Junipero Serra Elementary School. And if you're wondering what the heck Junipero Serra is, that's one of the founders of Ventura. He was a Spanish missionary, and that's pretty much what the whole city's named after. So Juana Maria and Junipero Serra Elementary Schools are the best for the East End. Okay, so we made it through all of the elementary schools. Let's go ahead and jump into the best middle schools for each area. Okay, best middle schools for each area, the West Side. And again, I mentioned this for the elementary school, and that is the Ventura Charter School of Arts and Global Education. They're a K-8, so I recommend having your child attend the charter school if you live on the west side. This is a twofer if you're in downtown or the Pierpont area. Your child will most likely be attending Cabrillo Middle School, and Cabrillo is another highly rated school. If you don't happen to want to send your kid to Cabrillo and you like a school on the east end, or you want them to go to the charter school, enter them in the school of choice lottery. There will be a decent chance that they can get in there. So if you're living in the college area or midtown, your child will be attending Anna Kappa Middle School, and that's where I went. It was a great experience for me. And what's something really cool with all California schools is that, yes, classrooms are indoors. When you watch a TV or a movie, you see that schools oftentimes are all inside with indoor hallways and stuff. Not in California. It's all outside, and it's really cool. And finally, for middle schools, if you're living on the East End, your child's going to be attending Balboa Middle School, and that is another wonderful place. My brother and sister actually attended Balboa Middle School. They turned out very well. My sister's now at Oxford, and my brother is about to graduate from Northridge, which is a local college in LA. Okay, we made it through middle schools. So now let's go ahead and talk about the high school options in Ventura. There are a few great options, and I love talking about this subject. So if you live on the west side, your child is going to be attending Ventura High School. They are home of the Cougars. That's a wonderful school. It's a really cool location. It's just located right next to downtown Ventura. If you also happen to live in downtown and Pierpont, your child will also be attending Ventura High School. So that's a threefer: west side, downtown, and Pierpont. Even some parts of midtown, your child will be attending Ventura High School. So let's go ahead and move to Midtown and the college area. Buena High School, and that's where your child will be attending. That's where my sister went. And again, I said she's now at Oxford, so it's a great school. The East End as well is the Buena Bulldogs. So if you're living on the East End, that dusty area that I mentioned, which has beautiful homes but slightly dusty, your child will be attending Buena High School. But there are a few other options that I want to share with you in this video that I believe could benefit your child depending on their situation. There's Foothill High School. It's a technological high school. It's based off of a lottery, and it's more of the midtown east end areas. So if you live there, you're gonna have a better chance of getting in. But they're a great technological high school. It's a little bit higher rated than Ventura and Buena. They are the Foothill Dragons, so that's something to look into if you want your kid to go to a more technological high school. I strongly recommend looking into Foothill. Another wonderful option for high school is El Camino High School, and it's attached to Ventura College, which is their local JC here. What's wonderful about this place is it's, for the most part, it's all done at home. That's what my brother did. He was rowing in high school, and he wanted more time to focus on that sport. What he did was he attended El Camino High School. He would meet with his teacher once or twice a week and go over all of his courses and any questions he had. And then he would do the bulk of his work at home, which gave him a lot more time to focus on working out and going to practice for rowing. If you want your child to attend an independent study, you can also knock out a bunch of college courses while doing that. And on top of it, you're getting your work done at your own pace, so you can focus on whether you want to be a pro surfer, a great athlete, wanting to attend a four-year and devote your time to exercising and practicing more, or whatever else it is, whether it's the arts. El Camino is another great option, and that's open to all of Ventura, something that I strongly recommend. And let's go ahead, since I mentioned it, Ventura College. Ventura College is such a fantastic option for your child to start going to school after high school. There's like a big push to get your kid into a 4 year so they can get a great job and be successful in life. However, I wish more people would push attending their local JC for 2 years and busting out a bunch of their general education while saving so much money. And what's really great about Ventura is we have the Ventura Promise, where if you graduate from a Ventura high school, you can go to VC for 2 years for practically free, knocking off all of your general education. And if you play any sports, you can go ahead and join their sports teams there, advancing your skills. So when you're ready to attend a 4 year, you got your general ed out of the way, you're staying in shape, getting good practices in with whatever sports team you're on. Ventura has just about all of them. And that's just another wonderful option for your kid to attend, or even you as an adult. There's so many continuing education courses, and it's just a really great place to learn. And the campus is also very beautiful. That's where I went for 2 years. I played water polo and I swam, and it was a really fun time. That's it for all of the schools in Ventura. If you found this information useful, go ahead and give me a like and subscribe for future videos about Ventura. And as always, if you're thinking of moving or selling in Ventura, California, I want to be your go-to resource. I love helping you out in any way that I can. I have all this information that I love sharing with you and helping you. So go ahead and contact me at any time. My contact info is in the description down below. And have a wonderful day.